I wouldn't have said that before. The guys, the biggest secret to creating passive income, there's nothing that's going to determine how far you go, financially speaking, at least, how much money you make, how passive your income is. If you want to make 30 grand a month passive income, nothing determines that more than creating equity. That's why, are we here? Are we right there? Okay, so Lightspeed Landlording, this is exactly what we're talking about. How do we pay off these properties as quickly as possible? 7 ways to pay off your rentals in less than 3 to 5 years. Yes, question? No, yeah, on the previous section, everyone totally done with the last one, right? So this is a, you said it's the one page part. 7 ways to pay off your rentals in less than 3 to 5 years. 10 to 30 grand a month of passive income at warp speed. What do you need to get 10 to 30 grand a month? Everybody should have this in 1 cent. Passive income equals equity times production. $1.5 million worth of real estate at 8%. That means you have 1% houses, 10 to 15 houses at 150 grand. Or if we're at 250 grand, we're talking about 6 or 7 properties. So we can collect the potential equity to make 10 grand a month in passive income. And like we had 90 days, 120 days. You can do this really quickly. It's not that hard to do. If we want to create a passive income of 10 to 30 grand a month, we can create passive income. It's not that difficult, right? Passive income, 10 grand a month, 30 grand a month, 20 grand a month, 10 to 20 grand a month, 30 grand a month. My goodness gracious, it's easy, you guys. Easy peasy. So 7 ways to pay off your rentals in 1 to 5 years. Again, these are accelerated payoff models. We want to use our mortgage calculations. We have the mortgage calculator in the back, the giant one you can calculate. Start paying off your mortgage. When we buy a property, we don't really have equity. We have potential equity, right? We don't really convert that potential equity into actual equity by paying down the mortgage. How many different ways are there to create equity, right? Three ways, right? So number one is we pay down the debt, right? Number two is we increase the income. Number three, we increase the value. Anytime you increase the income, you increase the value, but not necessarily increasing the value doesn't always increase the income. That's why they're two different things. So 7 ways to pay off your properties in 1 to 5 years. Accelerated payoff models. So number one is velocity banking, which means basically you take one lower income debt, you pay off a bigger debt. This is often, and I know people, this is a huge thing because I used to sell this, did this product as well. A lot of people think it's like they freak out about this. You take your credit card or whatever, you use one area of banking to pay off another. If you take a 30-year mortgage and you pay it down, could you pay it down in 10 years or a 20-year mortgage? Actually, we are using what was the property we used? So this is the numbers of this. So this is a 20-year property on a $200,000 20-year property. We did the math on this. So this is the mortgage calculation on this. So if you use velocity banking, you could do it in about 10 years. Now you could do it faster than that if you use income. But if you only use the income from the property, you take a 20-year mortgage, like a 10-year, something like that. And that's the best case scenario. Often, a lot of times for velocity banking, it makes more sense just to pay extra payments instead of putting a bunch of money down, just pay an extra $1,000 a month, $2,000 a month. So you have to compare that. Not always the best case to go with velocity banking. That's one choice. That's number one, velocity banking. Number two is biweekly payments. This was huge like the 80s and 90s. You know, you make 2 payments a month instead of 1 payment a month, and you end up making or 2 half payments a month instead of 1 full payment a month, and you end up making an extra payment a year. That could take like a 30-year mortgage to 23 years. It depends on the loan and the product and the credit of the person. But right now for that 20-year mortgage, that was basically prime, just above prime. They, prime plus one, I believe, they had biweekly payments and it took it from 20 years to 17 years, right? So just, you know, pointless. The other option we have, number three, is we pay down with extra cash. So we take down all the properties. So we're getting about that, the payment on that 20, the gross income on that duplex is $2,000 a month. The payment on that $200,000 mortgage is $1,200. So if we take that extra $800 or whatever it's going to be, we're calculating all the extra money. We throw that down on the mortgage. That takes that mortgage down to 12 years, almost half, right? So we have a 20-year mortgage. We pay off in 12 years if we just take all the extra cash and we dump it down on that mortgage. Now, number four, put all the cash down from all the properties onto one, and that does it in 7 years. That's actually not accurate, but we're assuming that you have 3 or 4 or 5 properties, right? So let's say you buy 5 properties and we structure them all the same. So you're going to have about $500 positive, $500 to $1,000 a month positive cash flow. Let's take all the money from all those properties, all the positive cash flow that you have, and we even factored in costs of maintenance and all that stuff. So we're buying 3 to 5 properties. Let's take all the positive cash flow you have and let's throw that down on that one property, that first property, that 200 grand property, $200,000, 20-year mortgage, right? And throw that down and we pay it off in 7 years. So that's, you go from 20 years to 7 years. That's pretty significant, right? Hey, if you just take the extra income, that does require that you have 5 other properties though that are all cash flowing. Number five, put all the cash down and then one $20,000 burr deal, just do one burr deal. So let's do one burr deal. We're not going to do a flip. We're just going to do one burr. It means you're going to make less money. Remember, all burr means is we buy a house, we're fixing it up and selling it. The difference is two things. Number one, we're only selling it for 80%, 80, 85%. We usually go 80%. And number two, you're the buyer, right? That's all. So that's a quick way to look at burr. So we're going to do one burr deal where you get to hold on to the deal. It's a flip, but you're holding on to it and it's at 80%. And we're going to take that money you get, that extra cash you get, and we're going to throw that down on the mortgage. This makes a huge difference, guys. Because if we take all the cash from all our rentals, we buy 5 rentals, we take all the cash. This is in that calculator. I didn't put this on here because it's all the math that's going to get bundled up. But look on the back. It's actually, you can look at this math here. And we take all that cash, put on that property. And on top of that, we do just one deal in the next year. We do one $20,000 burr deal, right? We take that 20 grand and we throw it down on that mortgage. We pay off that property in 3 to 5 years. Isn't that crazy? 3 to 3 to 5 years I can pay down that property. Guys, this is exciting. This is how quickly we can get to the place of people that talk about going to college, like 4 to 5 years, 8 years, 10 years, 15 years. And I agree, you should absolutely do that, especially if you're going to be a doctor or a surgeon or something. But think about that same, this investing in the same way, especially when you use the money recycler. Once you put your money in, once you have $100,000, is, you know, it may not be yours if you're still doing active investing, get to the place where you've got the $100,000, then turn to the passive stuff and get this going, man, because it just runs on its own, runs in the background, gets you your 10, 20, 30 grand a month at light speed, you know, 3 to 5 years, man. All we're doing, this is not like every single hero we're working with is either doing this or on the way to doing this, right? This is why we're basically done with working with investors, because we're doing this with everyone. With this exact process, we tell everybody, we say, listen, there's only 3 reasons to flip any real estate. Number one is that you need to get into a position where you can do buy and hold. Number two, you need to pay down, or you need to pay for the negative cash flow you have for buy and hold. It means you bought a property usually on the coast, high appreciation areas, have negative cash flow every month. Or number three, you need to pay down the mortgage on your buy and hold properties, right? And that's what this is. Let's take all the cash from all 5 of our properties and throw it down on one property, and let's just do one burr deal a year, and then we will pay that property off in 3 to 5 years. You show me an easier, quicker way to pay off a property in 3 to 5 years without doing crazy stuff. This is not like out of the ordinary stuff. It's very easy to do. We're doing this right now for, you know, very accessible. I'm saying that because as we move on, all these are not that accessible. Number six, put all the cash down and the 20 grand burr deal and do a flip. Is it, how many flips is it? One? No, it's one flip. Just one flip. So we do one flip in the one flip per year, or one flip every 2 years, I think it was. So you only have to do like 2 flips, because, you know, if we're doing like 20, 30, 40 grand. So basically put all the cash down from all those other properties, do one 20 grand burr deal, and then do a flip. I think it's a flip every 2 years or whatever. In that case, you can pay that property off in 2 to 4 years. Wow, 2 to 4 years, right? Just doing flips on the side. We call it the slide flip, the flip mode, right? This is a little bit more skilled because you have to have a team doing this, especially if you're doing it passively. You have to have people that can go out there. They can not only manage the property, take all the cash and put it down. They can do that burr deal, but they can also do flip. They have to have enough leads, enough of a business, enough dexterity to be able to handle that. If they can do that, you can do this in 2 to 4 years. You can pay off that property in 2 to 4 years and pay off a number of properties really quickly. Now, number seven, this is the ultimate badass. This is where all of you are going to be, because the core, a lot of the passive investors we work with, we did not train them to be active investors. Every single one of you, anybody that's here at Big Re, or anybody that actually goes through our stuff, has actually studied my stuff for a while. You should be an active investor and then become a passive investor. And the number one reason you want to be an active investor is that you know how to put a model in place. Because check this out. If you put all the cash down, you put 20 grand burr, look at that calculation. Yeah, that's what he was saying earlier. He said, wait till I get to it. You put all the cash down from the properties and you do a 20 grand burr deal, right? And you do on top of that, you have the flips. And on top of that, you put a model in place. A model should make you at least 10, 20, 30 grand a month. So you put a model in place, like the lender agent model, like the agent fist fight, like the bad inspection model, which is what exactly all the money, the 25 grand a week that he has, that's exactly where that's going. So you put a model in place, right? Now you pay that property off in 1 to 3 years. And even that's pushing it. That's what that 7 months is. That on this scale, we will have paid off that 200,000. You have your own. It's not 200,000. His is 130,000, but that's going to be paid off in less than 7 months. 130,000. You could pay off a $200,000 property in less than a year. If you have, think about it. If you're making 20 grand a month and you're throwing that entire amount down on a mortgage, I mean, you're going to have it paid off instantly. Now, some might say, why are you doing that if you're making 20 grand a month? Because that 20 grand a month is active income, right? If we want to create a passive, we can turn it, convert it over to real estate. And this is ultimately where this is the least accessible, the least likely to be. No ordinary person is going to, the only person that's going to be here is somebody I've trained or that we've trained, somebody somebody that's gone through our stuff, because nobody else is going to be able to put a model in place, make 10, 20 grand a month on the side real quickly, and then apply all that money, take all that money and throw all that down on that mortgage. That takes a very skilled person. This is a very, very unique individual. You know, I am saying 100%. You should be patting yourself on the back. I mean, this is a very, all of you should be trying to get to this level here. This is how, guys, you can go and create this passive income of 20, 30 grand a month. And you could do it. I mean, I don't want to start projecting too much, but I mean, just do this math on how quickly you could be there. If you're putting a model in place, the secret is you got to be able to put a model. You got to go through our stuff. You got to know how to do policies, run dialogue, gain compliance, do this stuff really quickly. Shouldn't take any more than 30, 60, 90 days for you to pull out 10, 20, 30 grand a month through active income, right? We convert that over to this passive model here, or to passive income, where we start getting up, get your numbers up there. And it becomes really easy. Say, you know what? I need 1.5 million at 8%. 1% houses. You know what? That ain't no thing. That's easy for me to do. What's the 2 million, 3 million. What do I need to do to get to 20 grand a month, 25 grand a month? We just move up our scale, go through our passive income guide and just move up that scale. Have that formula, every single one of you. That's why I said the first thing you should do, have that formula out. My passive income. Every day you should read it. Every day it should be on your mind. This is my equity target and what my production needs to be, my equity and production. And that way, when you put a model in place, you can see it. It's a crazy thing. Imagine doing the lender agent model. You go out and you put out a sign. You put put out a couple signs, you are ensuring that for the next 30, 40, 50 years, you're going to be making 10 grand a month in passive income. Whether you put out that sign, that it's like as simple as that. Put out a sign, not put out a sign. You know what I mean? It's really crazy. Man, I get emotional thinking about this stuff. Okay, so number one, let's go through this real quickly. Velocity banking, let's not even get into that. Bi-weekly payments, let's not do that. Pay down with extra cash. Now we're talking, right? Pay down with extra cash all from all your properties onto one. That's better. Pay down all the extra cash and do 120 grand bird deal. Easy. 3 to 5 years. This is like the perfect median of like somewhat badass, but also very accessible for anybody. So you should be doing that. Put down all your cash and a 20 grand bird deal and a flip. Oh my goodness. Put down all your cash, 20 grand bird deal, flip, and a model. You can have it paid off in 6 months, man. I'm not even playing. You can have it paid off before the seasons change, right? You can do this quickly, easily. Those are 7 ways of paying off your rentals in 1 to 5 years. Everyone got that? Make sense? Yes? Yes?